Blackstone presents Redemption, a novel by Mike Lawson. This book is read by Pun Bandhu.
Chapter 1. Redemption, Illinois. Population 8,000 and dropping with each passing year. A drowsy, unremarkable town, home to neither industry nor academia. A place surrounded by corn and soybean fields, where a four-story building is the tallest structure within 50 miles that isn't a grain silo. Jamison Maddox had been born and mostly raised in Manhattan, a city with a pulse, one with a throbbing, feckless heart. Manhattan was the center of the universe for finance, culture, and the arts, a mecca for the beautiful, the talented, the witty, and the rich. Manhattan was the only place Jamison had ever wanted to live and work, and yet here he was in Redemption, about to interview for a job he was certain he wouldn't want with a company that he'd never heard of. He knew he'd fallen far, but had never thought it would come to this. The unsolicited letter he'd received said the job paid only $120,000 annually. The amount wasn't negotiable, but if he was interested, he should come for the interview. The company would pay for his flight to Chicago, his rental car for the two-hour drive to Redemption, and one night in a motel. In his last job, Jamison made almost $1 million a year, his base salary augmented by his annual bonus, and he always got a bonus. For whatever reason, the interview was not taking place at the offices of Drexler Limited, the company that had recruited him. It was instead being held in a small diner, one with Norman Rockwell prints on the walls, and six red-top stools in front of a lunch counter. He took a seat at a table near a window where he could look across the street at a hardware store, a pharmacy, and a barber shop. The name of the street was, of course, Main Street. At 2 p.m, the diner had only two other customers, a couple of men sitting apart at the counter. One of them wore a white lab coat. Jamison figured he probably worked at the pharmacy and was taking a late lunch. The other guy was wearing denim overalls and a green and yellow John Deere ball cap. A large blue handkerchief drooped from his back pocket. An elderly man in a black suit carrying a briefcase stepped into the diner. His hair was white and full. He had bushy white eyebrows, thin lips, a prominent nose, and a blunt chin. His face was stern, hard, angular, what Jamison thought of as a Mount Rushmore face, one seemingly chipped from granite with jackhammers. He was a big, broad-shouldered old man, and not a kindly-looking one. He stood in the doorway for only a second before walking over to the table where Jamison was seated. He apparently knew what Jamison looked like, which wasn't surprising. Unfortunately, all it would have taken was a Google search to find a photo of him, one in which Jamison might have been wearing an orange prison jumpsuit. The old man moved as if his knees were bad, and his back was somewhat bent, diminishing his height. Had he stood straight, he would have been at least 6'4". He must have been an impressive physical specimen when he was a young man. Jamison smiled, stuck out his hand, and said, "Jamison Maddox, thank you for inviting me." The old man shook his hand. He didn't smile. His hand was larger than Jamison's, and although his fingers were swollen and gnarled from arthritis, he had a strong grip. He said, "Claude Drexler, I'm glad you decided to come, Mr. Maddox." The only waitress in the cafe, a slender blonde of 19 or 20, rushed to the table. "Can I get you anything, Mr. Drexler?" "Just coffee for now, Cindy. I might have some of your mom's apple pie later." Drexler studied Jamison, making a silent appraisal. And when he didn't say anything after a couple of seconds, Jamison pointed to a manila envelope lying on the table. "I brought my resume with me, since you didn't ask to see one before the interview." Before Drexler could respond, Cindy brought him coffee in a white mug. He thanked her, took a sip, then said, "I don't need to see your resume, Mr. Maddox. I believe I know everything I need to know about you. You're 28 years old. You graduated from Yale with a 3.7 grade point average. Your GPA would have been higher had you spent more time studying and less time socializing. You did your postgraduate work at the London School of Economics, after which you were employed by Goldman Sachs, where you remained until 2 years ago.
We hope you enjoyed this preview. To continue listening to this audiobook on Google Play Books, use the link in the video description.